Hello students, good morning. Today we shall discuss a few other concepts of the demand function chapter. Okay, today I shall tell you two things which mostly are important for short questions in this chapter. They are what is inverse demand function and the concept of discrete goods. These are very important from the point of view of short questions, either 1 mark, 2 mark, or 3 mark. So, what do you mean by inverse demand function? And also, what is the concept of discrete goods? Now, inverse demand function, we all know, in the demand function, we say that demand of a good is a function of the price. That is, demand of the product very much depend upon the price of the product. That is, higher the price, demand falls, lower the price, demand rises. There is inverse relationship. So, price or demand is a function of price. This is demand function. Now, if you say what is inverse demand function, this is just the opposite one. In inverse demand function, we have price is a function of demand. Demand is a function of price. This is demand function. And in inverse demand function, just the opposite. That is, price is a function of demand. That is, in this, we show how much will be the demand of a product if there is a certain change in price. Okay, let us take the example of Cobb-Douglas demand function. Here x is the product, x is equal to, let's say, alpha m by p1. M is money supply, p is price. So here x means demand for the product is inversely related to price and directly related to money supply. Now let a is equal to alpha by alpha plus beta. So instead of alpha, we can write a. Now, if you write a, if you substitute a with alpha here x is equal to a into m by p1, then we can take the p1 again here and x here through. So, p1 is equal to a into m by x. So, what is this? Here in the first one, x is equal to alpha into m by p1. Here, demand x is a function of, or inverse function of, it is a p1, one price. Demand is a function of price, but here price is a function of demand. Okay, demand and price, they are always inverse relationship. So if demand is a function of price, then it's direct demand function. If price is a function of demand, then this is indirect demand function. Okay, remember, this is more important for short question point of view. So prepare this in just 4-5 lines or even one line so that you can write it better in the examinations. So this is called inverse demand function. Simply, demand function means demand is a function of price. Inverse demand function means price is a function of demand. That is, the quantity that a consumer consumes in the market, at what price? That is, now in that function, what do you say? Demand is a function of price. So demand rises or falls, that depends upon price. But here, price is a function of demand. That is, according to the demand, price will rise or price will fall. That is called inverse demand function, right? So next we come to concept of discrete goods. Now, discrete goods are those goods which are found in indivisible forms. Discrete goods are found in indivisible forms, means not in divisible forms. They are found in whole numbers. Whole numbers means in integer forms. Okay, the goods which are found in indivisible forms, they are called discrete goods. You can't just subdivide them. Let me take the example of an ice cream. An ice cream is available at a whole pack. It's not available in small quantities. You can't take one scoop of ice cream and you cannot have it. You have to purchase that ice cream cup or you have to purchase that chocobar, then only you can consume it. So that's available in a whole pack. Therefore, that is a discrete product. So in a discrete product, in a discrete good, we consume goods in whole numbers, in integers, in a aggregative form, in a total form. So in that case, if suppose a person's income is money is M, if you want to buy one product, let's say product is, you want to purchase one product, so if I want to purchase one product, so the total money left with me will be M minus P1. If I want to purchase two products, then the money left with me for other products will be M minus P2. P2 means two products. Therefore, discrete goods are the goods which is available. If I say I want an ice cream, then you have to purchase one ice cream. Then you have, if you want more, you can purchase one more new ice cream, but that is in a whole pack. Okay, so that is a discrete good. They are called discrete goods. Goods which are available in a very small quantities in individual forms, they are not discrete goods. Now, in case if you talk of discrete goods, demand function of discrete goods, then before you go to the demand function of discrete goods, you should know what is reservation price. The reservation price. Reservation price means a price. Again, this is important for not question. This is important for not question. Reservation price. Reservation price is the price at which a consumer is indifferent whether to purchase a commodity or not to purchase. He is indifferent. Or I can say, in other words, I can explain, reservation price is a price. Or reservation price is the highest price that a buyer is willing to buy and the lowest price that the seller is willing to sell. That is the highest price a buyer is ready to pay to buy that commodity, and that is the lowest price which the seller is willing to sell. Below that, he will not sell. Okay, and or if the price is still more, the buyer is not going to buy. So reservation price is a price where a consumer, a buyer, is indifferent whether to buy of the good or not. Because that is in a whole quantity, you know. You cannot just subdivide it. You have to purchase the whole number. Now, in this case, in case of discrete goods, what will be the demand function? Let us say, look at this diagram. Let's say the price is OP1. This is price of good X, this is good X. The consumer wants to purchase good X. So if this is the price of good X is OP1, the consumer is willing to purchase, you see here, one quantity of good X. He wants to purchase one quantity of good X. So at OP price, the consumer's choice is one quantity of good X. So this is his reservation price. That is, at this price, OP1 price, he is indifferent to purchase one quantity or no quantity, zero quantity. So at OP1 price, his reservation price, he can purchase one quantity or no quantity at all. Let's say price falls to OP2. Now at OP2 price, the consumer is now in a position to purchase 2 units. You see here, he is purchasing 2 units. So now he is in a position to purchase more or 2 units. So he is in a position to purchase 2 units. It's not that he is ready to, he is going to purchase. Now, at OP2 price, his reservation price is from P1 to P2. Because at P1, he was ready to purchase one commodity. at P2, he is ready to purchase one more, that is two commodities. So from P1 to P2, his reservation price has is such that he is ready to purchase one more unit. If the price still falls to P3, now he is ready to purchase three units. At P4, he is ready to purchase four units. So the reservation price at P3 is P3 minus P2. At P2 is P2 minus P1. Therefore, reservation price means the price at which the consumer is ready to purchase a commodity or go without it. And this is the price, or this is the maximum price which a consumer is ready to pay, and the minimum price the seller is ready to sell for that. Therefore, reservation price we talk of because we purchase the commodity in whole, not in part, not in individual forms. So it's a discrete good. So we talk of individual goods, right? So here reservation price is different. Here reservation price is OP2. Here reservation price is OP3. Here reservation price is OP4. Okay. So this is the demand function of discrete goods. So when you talk of the discrete good demand function, you have to know. You have to know what do you mean by reservation price and how the reservation price. Actually, the reservation price concept comes in case of auctions, in case of auction sales. There is a reservation price below which the government will not come to sell or people will not sell, and above which the buyers may not go to buy. But here we talk of reservation price because at reservation price the consumers are indifferent whether to go with the product, whether to buy with the product or to go without it. Therefore we call this as discrete goods. Okay. So thank you very much. Next time, I'm asleep, I'm out in Luakam Sukujiba. Okay, have a nice time.